this.
Grab those. Ben Simeon used to do that.
Hello.
I do love a big gallon. I'm for a big pistol. I'm not after Simeon died. Simeon was, he was an inspiration to me.
I think I've seen you and Simeon do something.
Carol, let's do that. Wild side line.
Oh, okay. Well, I like the wild side line.
You started off with a C. Maybe
a G.
One more chair.
Thank you.
fallen leaves?
Right, fallen leaves.
Fallen leaves. Acorn.
Okay.
Acorn.
Fallen leaves that lie scattered. Yeah.
Try C. We're gonna play This Land Is Your Land.
Oh.
I think everybody here can, probably. Also known as the Mike Hogg. Well, let me check my little book here. I keep everything here in alphabetical order. Yeah, that's my name, Russ Phoenix.
was you down in Mission, Texas last February the 13th?
Well, let me check again here.
What's that come under?
It comes under, yeah, my mind's slipping.
Paper, places
or comes
ground.
Under places and people and things. Yeah, I was there.
Yeah, well.
We were there for hamburger night in Mission,
Texas. Yeah, hamburger night at the Mission West.
Yeah.
And when we went into that hamburger night, did some guy, lady named Mangie, come in with one of them big accordions, great big ones, and sat down right beside you at that jail?
Well, let me check that out again. Let's
What's
see.
That going to come up?
It comes under A for aggravation.
Aggravation, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Did Mangie come in?
She came in and she played that big old thing and it just...
Well,
yeah, she played.
After that jam, did you and Mangie go over to her travel trailer and work on some new material?
Yeah, let me check on that again. New shows. Yeah, by golly, we did. We went back to her trailer and we played till 4 in the morning.
New material till 4 in the morning?
Yeah.
Well, I'm telling you, buddy, Mangie's my wife and I don't like it.
Well, I'll tell you this, but I'll look under here again. You know, I didn't like it either.
Thank you. doing the story of the life of Jesus, and John the Baptist is standing on the banks of the Jordan River, and he sees Jesus walking toward him, and he says, "Behold the Lamb of God." And Jesus came to John and asked him to baptize him. And John said, "You come to me and ask me to be baptized? I have need of being baptized of you." And Jesus told him, he said, "Suffer it to be so, because we must do this to fulfill all righteousness." So John baptized Jesus. And when he was coming up out of the water, the heavens opened, just parted. And there was the dove that was seen coming down to Jesus. Now John had been told earlier, when he was called to be a forerunner of Jesus, "The one that you see the Spirit of God descending on like a dove, that's the one that you are the forerunner of. He's the one that you're going to be preaching about." So this was a witness to John that this truly was the Son of God. But there was also something else that happened. There was a voice that came from heaven, and it said, "This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased." So Jesus was baptized of John, and then he left and began to teach and to preach. And he needed some disciples, and as he was going along the Sea of Galilee, he saw Peter and Andrew, his brother. And he called to them, and he said, "If you will follow me, I will make you fishers of men." And you know, I can just imagine Peter, here he was kind of a rough and tumble fisherman, and just think what happened to him after he followed Jesus. He became the leader of the disciples. He was very important in the New Testament. So after he had seen Peter and his brother Andrew and called them, they were going along the river by the lake, and he saw James and John, and they were in the little ship with their father, and they were mending the nets. And he called them, and he said, "Follow me." And so Peter, James and John just climbed out of that boat, and they left that net mending to their father, and they immediately followed Jesus and Peter and Andrew and went with them. So Jesus was going along, and he was teaching as he went. He was healing people as he went. And he saw Philip, and he said, "Philip, follow me." And Philip, instead of just going with him immediately like the others did, he went to get somebody. So he went to Nathanael, and he said, "Nathanael, I have found the one that was spoken of by Moses and the prophets, and this is the one that we've been waiting for, and this is Jesus, the son of Joseph of Nazareth." Nathanael said, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" I don't know what was wrong with the reputation of Nazareth, but he was very impressed with him. And Philip told him, he said, "Come and see." So they started to where Jesus was. And as they got close, Jesus spoke and he said, "Behold, an Israelite indeed in whom is no guile." And Nathanael looks at him and he says, "And how do you know me?" And Jesus said, "When you were standing under the fig tree before Philip found you, I saw you." That really shook Nathanael up. And he said, "Rabbi, thou art the Son of God." So he was made a believer also. And Jesus said, "Nathanael, you believe because I told you that I saw you when you were standing under the fig tree?" He said, "You're going to see angels ascending and descending upon the Son of Man. You're going to see a lot greater things than just that." And they went on with their teaching ministry. And everywhere that Jesus went, he was healing people. And the scripture says that he healed the ones that were lunatic, the ones that had palsy, the ones that were crippled. It didn't make any difference what they had wrong with them. Jesus healed them. And so he was collecting his disciples to work with him and to go about in this ministry. And everywhere he went, when Jesus said, "Follow me," people followed him. And you know, today we need to be the same way. When Jesus speaks to our heart and asks us to make our lives right with him, we need to follow him.
Amen. Well, here'll be a good like song to follow. In G chord.
Imagine a world where no one playing bad. I play that too.
Now I'm playing bad, Frank.
Thank you. that song. Well, you get a line, I get a pole, honey.
Back.
key of D.
It's key
of R. How's that sound?
Good.
Get ready.
Can you play, Sarah?
Sure she can play.
In the key of D, she can.
Yeah.
because it just kind of wrote itself, called We're Gonna Waltz Across Walmart. Ah, when we shop together, our world's in disguise. It's a very glad day, and come through. And with your cart, by mine, dear, we could shop on and on. Even shop across a Walmart with you. Shop across a Walmart. no bad song, though.